I don't know if it's the weather or the holidays coming up or something, but I was tired this morning. It is, what time is it? It's 5:40 in the morning, and I like could not get out of bed. I usually would be up almost an hour ago. I just couldn't do it. Couldn't bring myself to get out of bed. I'm obviously doing a little bit of vending right now, and then most importantly, we've got some instances to run, which I'm excited about. I'm really excited about. This is all junk. Yeah. I'm good with that for now. So, I've been looking for this instance. Dungeon Finder. Specific dungeon. The Escape from Durnholde. I thought it was the Escape from Durnholde Keep. Escape from Durnholde. I've been excited for this instance for, honestly, like weeks at this point. And, oh yeah, it's holiday season now, isn't it? Do all the innkeepers have stuff or just... Yeah, be careful. It's Winter Vale, right? Winter Vale. I'm out of the loop, obviously. Anyway, it's Winter Vale. That's kind of cool. But I've been excited about this instance for quite a while now, and I don't know. I've been really slow with this character lately. I realize I haven't really been getting a lot of episodes out. I've just been busy, basically, unfortunately. How do I want to do this? Let's go over here, and we'll work our way east. Counterclockwise. Yeah, I don't know. It's just been a busy few weeks, and I'm back on a kind of a normal schedule now, which means obviously the holidays are coming up, so that's gonna delay things a bit. But for the most part, I'm anticipating being able to just hopefully get a little bit of stuff done every day for my YouTube channel. I really miss this character. I haven't played him as much as I would like, and I was really expecting to hit 70 like a week ago. I'm obviously well behind on hitting 70. The leveling has slowed down a bit anyway, I've noticed. Like, it just takes a little bit longer. We're also looking for Iron Jaw while we come over here. I don't think he's actually in this spot, but I will eventually need Iron Jaw. I actually need to kill some Defenders, some Blood Warders, and some Warlocks. And our goal today is to try to hit 67 and also do Skip from Durnholde, because what we really want to do is get into... Shadowmoon Valley, so that seems kind of cool, kind of fun. And then once we get into Shadowmoon Valley, hit go like a level out there or so, and then move to Wrath of Lich King content, which I guess is Northrend, which I really don't have a lot of experience in at all, but I'm certainly looking forward to that. Because honestly, that's kind of like the coolest thing. Like, this has been fun being out here in Burning Crusade content, but I've really like never seen Northrend. It's gonna be probably quite a bit different than everything else I'm used to. I should really cast some Chaos Bolts, shouldn't I? Man, I love those things. I'll never get tired of that. Got some Signets, which I think are just repeatable reputation things at this point for us, if I remember right. I think we had a one quest for those, and then it became a repeatable quest. So. No rush in turning those in. I don't really worry about reputation grinds while I'm leveling. It just doesn't seem that important or that much. Is that? Huh. Oh, I see this, like, these shadows over here. Like, what is that? It's like this giant shadow and it's that thing. It kind of scared me. It looked like a zeppelin was flying over me or something. I'm not really sure what I thought it might have been. But it was a little bit. Like, look at that shadow. It's kind of large, is all I'm saying. And it just sort of. Threw me off. I don't know if throw me off is the right word, but kind of made me nervous. I don't know what I expected was coming from there, but nothing obviously too bad, but just a little, just, I don't know. Like I said, kind of made me nervous. Well, that's dead. Oh, there's a lot of Warlocks here, but I really feel like finished my Warlocks off real quick on that quest, and I actually need other stuff done now. I didn't realize I was only killing really Warlocks there. Fine. That's this. So, yeah, Durnholde Keep, or Escape from Durnholde, I guess is the name of the instance, truthfully. I keep thinking Durnholde Keep. My expectation is to do a little bit of exploration in there, not just rush through and clear it. I've heard there's all cool things, because I guess it's set in Hillsbrid. Like old Hillsbrid, like ancient Hillsbrid or something like that. So that's kind of neat. Let's get this one. Yeah, so it's supposed to be some fun things to look at there, so I'm excited to kind of check it out. I don't know. All I know is that I'm supposed to look at, like, if I can, Terran Mill, but definitely at least South Shore. Oh, what's this thing? Warp of translocation. I mean, I guess it's going to trap, like, move me. Interesting. I'm not really sure being up here matters at all, but sure, let's take a look. At least got me another mobby kill, so I can't complain. What are those called? Blood Warders? Huh. Let's see a few more, maybe, over here. What is this? Let's sprint over here. Nifty. This is kind of cool. I don't really know. I really don't know why. What these are doing, but. Ooh, stamina scroll. I'll take that. I almost always use scrolls again, so they just, like, that is not worth saving, in my opinion. I used to save them in vanilla for raiding. Huh. Interesting. That's kind of fun. I used to save them for raiding because, honestly, like, every little stat point you could get was probably worth it in vanilla, but I'm not really convinced it's that interesting or needed here, so I don't worry about it too much. Now, I am gonna go this way. There we go. I was gonna say, there's gotta be some more mobs over here to kill. What do I need now? 4 more defenders? Okay. I guess the 7.3.5 changes, I think they're rumored to come out. A friend of mine told me, and I'm forgetting now, I thought by like mid-January sort of the rumor. So that should change my leveling quite a bit. It's going to be interesting to see. I haven't been on the PTR at all, and I haven't really looked in to stuff that's on the PTR. Like, I generally don't look ahead on stuff. Pretty much if I'm spending time on WoW, it's because I'm playing WoW. I don't generally have a lot of extra time, unfortunately, to, like, look at other content related to it, but not actually just play it. So I really don't know much about what's going on. Oh, it's a quest over here. I'll take that. Is this, like, save someone from being captured quest? You can probably make that happen. Is there anything else up here before I get do this quest? I wish I could just, like, stand on the thing without falling. I kind of need to kill 2 more defenders, and if they're just, like, right out here, it'd be nice to just finish them, you know? Just be done with that. There's a defender, let's kill this. And there's a translocation orb. Let's take it and see what happens. Probably warps me up higher, maybe? Oh, nice. Oops. Let's do this. Perfect. Very satisfied with this. That was a good decision to come up here. I think we got exactly what we needed. And oh, can't go that way. Sure, let's immolate this thing. Immolate and our ample finished up. I guess I do want to loot it, though. I guess there's another translocation orb to send me back to the entrance, then. Ooh, who's this? Sharth Voldoon. I have a feeling I have to come back and kill Sharth later. Sharth, what a terrible name. Sharth. Huh. That's an awful name. But I have a feeling we'll come back and kill Sharth later on, but I can just fly up here, so. Really, no need to take the long way, I guess. Whoa. Oh my god. What are the odds that someone else came into the quest while I was doing that? You just, like, I had that concern, and I'll tell you what, unlike a classic server, I'd be more concerned about that happening, because there's a lot of people usually out leveling around you, but I didn't really expect that to happen here. I'm gonna turn this quest in case it comes back and has me kill that guy up top there, in case it's like a follow-up. I just didn't expect to see anyone out here. Like, I'm genuinely surprised that I just got that quest snatched from me. I honestly had that concern. I was like, oh man, what if someone takes it? I was like, nah, there's no one out here. I never see anyone. No one else is leveling anymore. What can nope. I do for you? Wrecked. Lieutenant Meriden wants you to use the final code to set off the mana bomb. Go with honor, friend. Okay. Well, I'm here anyway, so I guess it was a follow-up. It wasn't the follow-up that I expected, I guess. Where is the mana bomb? This looks like the mana bomb. So probably want to kill this guy. That works. Requires the final code. Well, I should probably read the quest, shouldn't I? Okay. Got it. Yep, I was right. I didn't need to kill Sharth. Interesting. Where is Sharth? Up here. Hopefully Sharth has respawned. Like the little island right there is kind of floating. That's kind of cute. Alright, Sharth, please be back. You scumbag. Oh, hey. Perfect. This will be an easy kill. Would have been nice to get a crit there. Sharth himself. Done. Do I have to open this or anything? Use. Activate. I thought for a second, I had like a heart attack there for a moment. I thought I accidentally had a non-flying mount, and I thought I just ran off the cliff. That was kind of... That was like... I had a moment of fear that I just... like, literally just suicided off the cliff there, but I did not, so it's okay. That worked well. Inputting the final code. Why would they keep a mana bomb in the middle of there? Seems like a terrible plan. I guess I should get out of here. I don't know, I'm just saying, like, maybe I shouldn't be there. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I guess that was it. Huh. Okay. Well. Alright, where is Iron Jaw? That escort I got. I'm really sad I didn't get to do that escort quest. I really thought that's gonna be my escort quest to do. I could go back, but I don't know. I'm not that desperate. Okay, where is our little stone gazer? Who's this? I don't think we need Stonegazer, but I'm gonna go ahead and kill him anyway. Just in case he drops anything. I know this is probably like a different kill quest. Like, I'll probably come back and have to kill Stonegazer, but eh. Iron Spine. Chunko Basilisk. Cool. Huh. Iron Jaws. I know it's a wolf. I just. Or Dire. What are these things called? Timber Wargs. I know it should be like a different color than the rest, right? I remember, I did find him that one time, I did see him out here, I'm not going to spend a lot of time looking for him. Like, last episode I think it was, I saw him, I was like, oh, I'll kill this in case it drops something interesting. A little silly, maybe. Well, I don't really want to hang around here forever, looking for a named mob that I don't really care that much about. Let's go up here. How are we doing on our instance? We have everyone but the tank, good, good. Moving on up. So, I'll be doing some exploration in the instance. Once we're done, when I get in the group, I'm going to send a quick message to everyone, like, hey, when we're done with the group, I'm going to explore a little bit on my own, just FYI. Because apparently, sometimes, you know, people want to do, like, multiple instances with that group, and I don't want them to think that I'm just being, like, a jerk or something, so. Okay, looking for some named mobs here. Looks like one of them might be. There's one in that. I was gonna say, looks like one of them might be in here. Let's take it out. Always a good time. Okay, where's the other one? Looks like the other one is over there. What is here? Talonites and sorcerers I need to kill. Okay, we can do that. Out of range? What? There we go. Yeah, so killing some trash mobs, I can take care of that real easy. Looks like there's a lot of sorcerers here. What is that called? Laughing Skull Cap of the L. I don't even have this in my appearance yet. Glad I grabbed it. It doesn't look that much different than the current hat I have, so it's interesting. Hmm. It actually would be an upgrade in versatility and intellect, but I'd lose 23 stamina, I think. 23 stamina is worth more to me than the intellect and versatility. That could be a mistake, but I'm gonna stick with it. I've been told many times that it's not that important to my gear at this point. Like, my gear will, I'll pick up gear pretty fast anyway. I shouldn't worry about it too much. And it's true, I have noticed I pick up gear very quickly in general, and I know that, like, in 10 levels, I'll probably, hopefully, will replace all the gear I currently have equipped anyway, so, why worry about it? There's a lot of these, like, kill mobs X times quests out here. You know, like, ooh, what's that? Level 70 troll warlock, neat. Sometimes I'm glad I'm on a PvE server. Like, I know it's a little bit boring, but sometimes it's kind of nice to be on a PvE server. It lets me kind of level up my own, I don't know, discretion. I have not summoned a Doomguard in far too long. Whoa, what was that 3,000 damage crit? I don't know what that was. That was pretty sick. I appreciate that. Alright. What's our group looking like? Man, warriors are in high demand. Why is my... Oh my gosh, I accidentally pressed enter and I was like down here spamming. Hey, how are you? I was typing a message to someone. I didn't finish the message. Like, I didn't press enter. And then I kept, like, hitting, like, www, trying to move and all the other keys. And nothing was happening. I was like, why is my keyboard, like, broken? And I looked down, like, oh, I'm spamming, like, some crazy message. Here we go. We're in Durnholde. Or, Farms of Time. Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, right. This makes sense. Hi all, gonna explore after we're done, just FYI. Okay. Yeah, Caverns of Time. I remember exploring the Caverns of Time in vanilla, and you could do it by, there was a way to get in to this Caverns of Time area, not specifically Old Hillsbird, but into the Caverns of Time itself. You could sneak into it in vanilla, even though it wasn't accessible normally. Is one of the coolest. Truth is the version. I'm ready to go to Durnholde Keep. It's one of the coolest areas in vanilla WoW, but it was really well hidden. I mean, seriously, it was well hidden. Temporal illusion, disguised with a bronze dragonfly. Interesting. I need to look into the holiday stuff, the Feast of Wintervale. This is my first Wintervale in Legion ever, because I started playing Legion around March of 2017. That's when I started doing that series of my Rogue. That was literally like, I mean, that was it. I hadn't really touched it. So we're heading to South Shore. I remember a little Snapjaws are still here. Doing little snapjaw stuff. Vicious Grey Bears. Yep. Guess we're not going to South Shore. This music sounds a little familiar. I don't know if it's like a Warcraft 3 song or something. Or Warcraft 2? That doesn't make sense. Maybe. We took, like, the weirdest route. We, like, flew, like, down. I guess we didn't take that weird route. We just could have flown straight across, but, eh. Okay. So what are we fighting? Captain Scarlock, Lieutenant Drake, got it. Okay, our group's very chatty. There are actually, like, a lot of messages talking about were they in a war, were in a battleground together, those other things. Discover Durnholde, okay. Roll out. I got this. Don't worry, guys. I don't need any help. I've got my handy-dandy Chaos Bolt. Heals, heads up, I'm gonna do big pulls. Okay, I'm gonna do some super fun Rain of Fire goodness then, if that's the case. We're doing big pulls, Rain of Fire it is. That's gonna be exciting. I'm looking forward to that. I guess Incinerate Spam here is kinda nice. Gonna hit a few targets at once at least, while I'm kinda building up some Soul Shards for Rain of Fire goodness. Okay, I do remember. I remember Durnholde Keep very clearly. I remember it being a very annoying place to level in, to be honest. I don't even know if Rain of Fire is like the best use of my. How many it uses? 3 soul shards? Yeah. It uses up so many that it's almost not worth. Hey, like, the work prisoners. Yeah, I remember this. But it uses up so many soul shards. I almost don't know if it's a good. Wait, where are we going? We're going behind. Huh. Interesting. Just Rain of Fire and this like group of them here. I don't know, probably seems like the best way to. Like, I don't know, AoEing probably is the best choice here. I wish I didn't use up so many soul shards. The Orc Prisoner says, when can we eat again? Cursed scum. That's what the Orc Prisoner says. Huh. Orc Prisoners. These were not level 65 though. When I was here, these were not level 65. Okay, I don't really know what's going on. I'm gonna mount up and follow these guys though. What was that? Durnholde Sentry. River Gloves, the Tiger Agreed. Okay. Yeah, the Orc Prisoners were not 65. Definitely not. I am very positive of that. Oh no, that I missed my Rain of Fire a little bit. That's okay. I should have aimed a little bit farther back. Yeah, life goes on. Just incinerate some mobs. I like these big pulls. These are nice. Looks like this is a way to do it. Like just pull everything at once. Stormguard and Munster. Munster cheese. Munster cheese is pretty good. Like. See these guys. Oh, I see what he's doing. Planting the bombs. Got it. Okay. I thought he was clicking on the orcs. I guess I got a cool enchant. I don't know what that is. Like electrical enchant? Looks nice. Okay. Bombs have been planted, I think.
What do you need?
I wish I could sit on these logs. I guess I can kind of sit, right? Like something like this. Alright, where are we going? Oh, I see. We blew up everything. The prisoners are escaping. Objective complete. Internment. Okay, yeah. Oh, there's our. Yep. Got it. I was thinking that. I was like, maybe we're just summoning the boss. I think that's how it works. It's like, why incinerate? Or why use immolate when they die so fast anyway? It's really no point. They die way too fast. Okay, ooh. Nope, leather. That'd be an upgrade for me. But they're leather, so not actually an upgrade. There's like a secret vendor up here. I don't know if that vendor's still here. Oh, it's funny, even Christmas decorations this time of year. That's a nice little touch for like an instance. That's one thing I always missed as a rogue. In vanilla, or even just really in general, but especially in vanilla, not so much in Legion, because you have some AoE capability. I really missed AoEing things, or being able to AoE things. It's so nice being able to AoE stuff now. Where are we going? This way? I didn't realize we had a gnome hunter with us. It's a tiny little gnome. Cute. Who is this thrall?
Loktar, friend.
Jerutha's diversion. Complete quest. Accept quest, sure. Let's go, Thrall. Let's get him out of here. It's interesting thinking about the Alliance saving Thrall, but it makes sense in this context. But oh yeah, here we go. Thrall's gonna get geared up. Oh, that poor armor. The armor says, "What's the meaning of this, guards?" And then Thrall says, "That's enough out of him."
This day is long overdue. Out of my way.
Thrall, that's not the way out. Thrall, where are you going? Thrall. He's too fast, I don't even know where he went. Oh, found him. Right? I guess it's the right room. Oh dear god, I'm gonna die.
You have forced my hand.
Almost. Almost gonna die. Huh. Okay, where's Thrall going now? Found him. I'm surprised I still have line of sight on that guy. There's no way I have line of sight. That's bizarre. I mean, it works for me, but I just didn't think I was anywhere near having line of sight on that guy once he climbed in the little thing. Okay, throw, where are we going? Oh, this guy says, the hunter in our group, the gnome, said he used to be a human hunter, and he changed it to a gnome when they enabled that as being an option. Huh. I was gonna say, why isn't Thrall gearing up? There we go. Makes more sense. Now he's ready to go. 23,000 health? Yeah, he's good. I should stop pulling aggro on all these guys. I don't know why I keep doing that. It's like a good way to get myself killed. Alright. A little Durnholde tracking hound. That's sad. I need to kill that thing. Rip. We're getting a reputation with the Keepers of Time while I'm out here. Which, yeah, that makes sense. Oh, we just lost someone. Who just died? I don't know. Someone just died. Simone. Simon? Simon? I don't know why I said Simone. Simon! Dead. Rip Simon. Alright, where's Thrall? I just lost track of him. There he is. I feel like we need to stay near Thrall, right? It feels like that's like the key here, is to stay near Thrall. Certainly we shouldn't lose him, I'm thinking. So I'm going to try and hold on to him. Cam all maxed out on soul shards. I don't think it's going to be hard, by the way. Like, I'm not like super worried about us like wiping or anything here, but I just am... that's some toy box stuff. I don't know why I never use my, I never ever use my trinkets or my toys on this tune. I just like, I guess I was, I'm still not used, to, I really am still not used to the idea that you can use items and mounts and stuff between different tunes. Like, they're account wide. Like, and I know I'm using the same mounts all the time here, but it's never, like in my head, I never think of it that way. Captain, this guy's getting awfully close to us.
Thrall, you didn't really think you would escape, did you? You and your allies shall answer to Blackmoor after I've had my fun.
I'm gonna cast bolt the big guy if I can. Seem good. Anyway, so yeah, Captain Scarlock himself, which is really not much of a threat, obviously. I think I just about finished him with the Chaos Bolt. Ooh, what's this? That's actually pretty much an upgrade for me, right? 3 intellect, 4 stamina, 1 crit, 7 haste, and 3 prismatic slots versus 10. You may not roll need on this? Oh, it's mail. I'm dumb. I really thought it said... I thought it was cloth. I'm stupid. For some reason I thought it was... Like, when I clicked it, I knew the icon looked like it was mail or plate, but I could have sworn it said cloth, and I was like, oh yeah, I'll take that. That looks like an upgrade. I'm really glad it didn't let me need on that. That's exactly why they added those restrictions, so dumb people like myself don't just click need on plate gear or mail gear. Aged Dalaran Wizard. What is this? Oh, that's cool. So like the only place you can, I bet that's like the only place you get that recipe. Did I just get demounted by standing on this bridge? What the heck? Okay, we're going for the Epoch Hunter at Terran Mill. I think it's the last boss, but once we do that, I'm going to explore Terran Mill a little. Then I'm going to go down to South Shore and explore a little bit. Man, I have so many good memories in Hillsbrood, even as a Horde. I mean, especially as a Horde, I guess, really. I think Horde level a little bit more in Hillsbrood than Hillsbrad. Hillsbrood. I think more people level in Hillsbrood as a Horde than Alliance, but there's a lot of Alliance, usually. Alright, what are we doing? Like, I don't know if I should lead the charge. Are we waiting for ready for Thrall, maybe? I don't know what's going on. That's a cool mount. Red Flying Cloud. Neat. Reminds me of... little cloud from like a Dragon Ball that Goku would ride on. throw out some... I guess a little saucer thing kind of takes away from that. But like the cloud itself. Flying Nimbus, right? I mean, it makes sense. Nimbus clouds type of cloud. Okay. I'm going to ask the group. Are we waiting for Thrall? Or what? I mentioned it's my first time here because I have no idea what's going on. Yeah. Someone's got a trap here. It makes you think that, like... Okay, we're waiting for Thrall, they said. There he is. Cool.
What is it you wish?
In we go. What is around the corner? A horse over here that we can't click on. And a horse we kind of can click on. Yeah. Hey! There's a horse called Old Blanchy in Westfall. At least in Vanilla. Stay out. Oh. Someone says stay out. Got it. Now I understand why we're staying out. Because we're going to kill these guys out here. Not that it's probably a huge... Like, I'm sure we'd have been fine if we'd went in there, but... Down here, they're like, the guys are like... The Terran Mill lookout said, I thought I saw something going to the farm. Going to the barn. I didn't see anything. Something riled that horse. Let's go. Anyway, the point being, Young Blanchy, I'm suspecting, is the young version of Old Blanchy, which is a horse in Westfall that... I recently did a video on bags in Vanilla WoW or Classic WoW, and like kind of where to get them and that sort of stuff. And for those wondering, Old Blanchy is the name of a quest. I think it's the name of a quest. But there's a, you get a bag for a quest related to Old Blanchy that's called like Old Blanchy's Feed Bag or something. It's like a 4-slot bag, which is really nice. At like level 11 you can get it. It's actually a big deal, I think. So, not the craziest thing ever, but Old Blanchy is actually very relevant. Ooh, should probably kill these things. It's actually very relevant for if you want to get a bag in Classic WoW. Might as well explore up here a little. What's this? Taritha? That looks kind of familiar. I don't know why. Taritha? I don't know. Sort of seems familiar. So basically we're running around just like nuking all these packs of mobs that spawn. I'm guessing that this glowy thing around her is a sign that she's going to be... Ooh, is that an upgrade? No, definitely not. This is probably the Epoch Hunter? That's scary.
Aretha's life hangs in the balance. Surely you care, King. Surely you wish to save
her. I summoned the Doomguard a little early. Whoops.
There you are. I had hoped to accomplish this with a bit of subtlety, but I suppose direct confrontation was inevitable. Your future, Thrall, must not come to pass. And so, you and your troublesome friends must die.
Well, that was unfortunately a huge waste of my Doomguard, my bad. Oh, wow. There's more of them. Give me another pack, or is that it? Yes. Yeah. Yeah, I think Rain of Fire is good for these bulls. I gotta loot them. Nice. Belt. Mail belt. Nope. Not for me. Okay, that's kind of a cool fight. I like it. It's kind of interesting fighting inside of Terran Mill itself, but you don't really have a lot of opportunities to fight. I mean, I don't know. It's kind of cool fighting in a town. Leather gear. I don't need that. Alright, well, that was cool. Nothing too complicated there. Now, for me, I guess my quest was completed, right? Experience gained 46,000 experience. Really nice. Okay, let's go explore. Gonna explore the zone. Thanks all. Escape from Durnholde Keep. Where do I turn this in? Speak with Erosion. I actually know where that guy is.
How are you?
Oh, hey. A random redding crops.
See you later.
Someone says, want to keep doing tasks? I'm like, sure. The way. Oh, there's our turn in. I was like, where's my turn in? That'd be a spot to turn this quest in. Erosion.
May you find what you seek.
Complete quest. Nifty.
Welcome. Browse at your leisure.
Huh. No.
Safe journey.
Sorry, no. Wanna explore here. Haven't been in this instance ever. Okay. Cool. So turn in our quest. That's what I was trying to do. I was like, where do I turn in that quest? Okay, so hopefully I can get down here to Terran Mill, or to South Shore. Do I get ported out if I'm the only one in the group? I don't think I do. I think I've been the only one in the group before. Huh. There's the towers. Nope. Decline. Sorry. I should know if this is the right way to South Shore. I don't really play a lot of Alliance tunes, so I'm somewhat unsure, but I think this is the right way. I know it's down here along the coast. I thought it was near, like, yeah, this is the right spot. I see it now, so obviously it is. What are these? Some kids? Jimmy Vicious? Vicious. White Mane, Mo Green. Hey, I don't know who Jimmy Vicious is, but Renault Mograin. Is this? I don't know the first. I mean, and White Mane. Those are the names from the people from Scarlet Monastery. So maybe this is like before they joined the Scarlet Monastery, like as kids. Hillsbridge citizens. Okay. Horse, just a horse. Nothing fancy there, okay. Who are these? What? The Curantor. That's crazy. I guess I don't know Kel'Thuzad's backstory, but I assume it's the same Kel'Thuzad. But Helcular, I remember this guy from the Horde quest. It's actually a really tough quest in vanilla. Kind of ridiculously tough. That's cool. Who are these people? Citizen. This is... those two up there, way cooler than these two that are here that are citizens. Very lame. No citizens. Super lame. Okay. Bartolo Gensetti. I don't recognize that guy at all. What's in here? Hillsbridge citizens. Hmm. Okay, what's up here? Who's that? Natasha Morris. The name doesn't ring a bell. Citizen. I'm just like psyched about Kel'Thuzad. That's really interesting. So Kel'Thuzad used to hang out in South Shore. If this is canon. I don't know if Old Hillsbridge is canon in the lore, but if it is, then at least we've got Kel'Thuzad as one of the things here. Harrod. Hey. Okay, so those are definitely Scarlet Monastery people. I definitely remember him from Scarlet Monastery also. He has good tank warrior gear. Or at least he did. I'm not actually super familiar with his gear now, but I'm sure it's similar. What do we have in here? Thanos Morris. Bilger the Straight-Laced. I'm sure these are people, but I don't... The only Nathanos I know is Nathanos Blightcaller from, I think, Eastern Plaguelands. I don't recognize the rest of these names. I'm now the leader of the group.
Yes.
Magistrate Henry Maylob. None of these really ring a bell. There's not really any chat going on down here. And you can't see the text, but they're not really saying anything, the NPCs. Who are these people? Citizens. Zixel, aspiring merchant. Hold on. I think I've seen this goblin merchant somewhere. Oh, hold on. There's so many things going on here. Captain Sanders and Edward Haynes. I don't recognize... Captain Sanders, I guess, is the same one. There's a Captain Sanders Lost Treasure map. It's a quest in... It's, again, that bag video I made recently. There's a quest there. You get a bag from that. But I don't know where... I don't know if I've ever seen Captain Sanders, but that's the quest. The other one I don't recognize. Edward something. There's Helkiller and Kel'Thuzad. Zixel, I think, is an aspiring merchant. Yeah, I think he might be a goblin merchant. Is he the one that roams around? Because there is a merchant that roams around in Hillsbred with this thing. I bet that's him. That's cool. And then, of course, I don't know who Hal McAllister is, but Nat Pagel is, of course, a very famous fisherman in WoW lore. And honestly, to be totally honest, the first time that I heard... my memory of Nat Pagel really comes from Hearthstone. Is the first time I think I remember Nat Pagel. I don't know if he was introduced after Burning Crusade or not. That's when I first remember him from Hearthstone as a card. Side note, Nat Pagel, there's a developer for WoW, programmer maybe, named Pat Nagel. So Nat Pagel is a play on Pat Nagel's... Nat Pagel is a play on Pat Nagel's real name in real life. So there's the kids running around. I'm so glad I got like a YouTube comment suggesting I look at this stuff, and I'm really glad I did, because this is really cool. I think it's the last spot in... Ooh. Okay, so I don't know which Mograine this is, but there's a Mograine in Scarlet Monastery. I think Fairbanks is also in Scarlet Monastery. Tyrion, Abendus, Isilien. This is the Scarlet Monastery in Arcanus Doan, yeah, of course, okay. I don't think Tyrion joined the Scarlet Monastery ever, right? I mean, I know he was on a boss, but I don't think he ever joined the Scarlet Crusade. He was like a different faction, I think. So maybe that's what these three over here are. Is they're on the opposite side of these. And if you look also at let's see this. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit here. They do have the same crests, like her crest and that. So maybe they're all on the same side right now. Okay, what do we have over here? Oh, the captains. And a magical broom, which is cool. Bartender, got anything good for us? I have so much gold. Let's get smashed. And some weak alcohol, which doesn't really do a lot, but it's kind of fun. There's chat going on down here. So Mogren says, so Thomas Yancey yells, don't take it from me what a bargain this is. Come see for yourself. Commander Mogren says, keep your voices down. There are strangers about. Brothers and sisters, I've called you here today to discuss the fate of Lordaeron. Mogren lowers his voice to a whisper. I hear things that should not be. The dead rise undead from the frozen Northlands. Whole cities have gone missing. I have heard that Northrend is lost. Gasps can be heard throughout the room. We must stand at the ready. I have faced undead before. They are ruthless killing machines, devoid of any emotion or compassion. Tyrion Fordring nods. Tyrion Fordring says, I've battled them as well. We are ill-prepared as a kingdom to withstand such an assault. And Doan over here says, what do you propose, Mograine? Mograine replies, I propose that we prepare our loved ones, family, and friends for the possibility of an undead holocaust. And there is this. I'm so psyched they're on menu. This is such a cool instance. Mograine unlocks the chest. What is that? Abendus says, by the light, what is it? Mograine says, I've had this object in my possession for 10 years, since Blackrock Spire. I arrested it free from the remains of an orc lieutenant, a dark caster. It is from their homeworld. Do not get too close. I laid a hand upon it once, only once and never again. The memories of that day still linger. Mograine removes the gauntlet from his right and shows everyone his mangled hand. So he's got a mangled hand. Okay. I surmise that this object is the living embodiment of shadows, darkness. It is a manifestation. It is a void. I do not see how this evil artifact is relevant to the undead. We must destroy it. This chef is over here saying some random stuff. Commander Mogreen, no old friend, is very relevant. Let me ask you this, brothers and sisters. Can good exist without evil? Can there be light without dark? And if the answer is no, then could it be possible that because this artifact exists, its polar opposite must also exist? Could you imagine what the material manifestation of the light could do against the undead? Isilian says, nonsense, Mogreen, it must be destroyed. Shock. Then silence overtakes the crowd. So it consumed the light. So like the guy there cast something and consumed it. Tyrion says impossible. Tyrion tries and fails. Someone's asking if it's getting lighter, if the coloration is changing. That's Fairbanks. They're just like, trying to nuke it with light, like holy spells. I have a bad feeling about this. Huh. Mogren says, by the light, could it be? Could this be it? I must know. I will know. Mogren reaches out to touch the crystal. The light crystal. It does not look good for him. He just sat down, kneeled down, and cried. Okay, he says, it is beautiful. What I felt when I touched it, the light coursed through me, and I through it. It healed my spirit. Your hand, it is healed. Huh. Okay, put the crystal back in the box. Let us never speak of this day. Our enemies are many. They need not know we hold such artifacts. This weapon will hold inside... I've seen it. From the blessed crystal, we will forge a weapon. This weapon will hold inside it a piece of each of us. And if when it is used against undead, I shall cast them down, and in its wake I will leave only ashes. Avast. Oh, wait, no, man, it's a captain talking. They called it the Ashbringer. Interesting. So that... I was wondering, what is this? What are they doing? So I think it's the end. And I don't really say anything. During that, the captains were over here chatting. They got drunk at the bar is what happened. And Captain Sanders says, Avast, Ed, let me show you my ship, Hick. And then, lead the way, Sanders. And that's basically it. But they were like chatting a little bit. So that's the Ashbringer. That's cool. I was wondering what they were making. Chef Jessen, yeah. Interesting. Anything down here? Nope. Doesn't seem like it. So that's cool. So that's the formation of the Ashbringer. What was the origin of that crystal, though? I don't actually know. I need to like look up the lore on the Ashbringer. Francis Lynn. Okay, who's this? Stalvin. Stalvin Mistmantle. Stalvin was a very long quest line in... I want to say, it's not Darkshore. It's stupid. I can't zoom out. Why am I forgetting the name? The Dark Forest south of Elwynn. Whatever it's called. I'm forgetting the name. Stalvin was a big quest there. Taelin. Taelin is the son of Tyrion, right? That makes some sense. He's got a huge hammer with a nice enchant on it for like such a little kid. Finn Odellic. I don't recognize Finn, but he's obviously Kirin Tor related. Cool. So that's interesting. I need to look up the rest of the lore. So I can figure out exactly where that dark crystal came from. I really don't know. Anyway, that's all for this instance. I think we can leave now. That's cool. That's really fun. I mean, we probably spent like 10 minutes just kind of messing around there, but that was fun. I enjoyed it. It was totally worth it. Like absolutely worth the time. Just kind of checking it out. All right, well, we're back in Terra Car. We're going to try to get level 67 today. I'm just going to whack this guy. And we should be able to do that pretty easily, because I think we'll have at least a couple of quests turned in here in just a moment. Oh, I got something in my eye. I just nuked that. What was that? That squirrel. That's sad. Yeah, so that was fun. That's a coincidence. I don't know... much about, like I said, I'm not like big on WoW lore. I like WoW lore, but I'm not like super familiar with a lot of it. But that seemed like one of the cooler instances in terms of stuff you can do or learn about. There's Ayet, or whatever. We already killed Ayet. We need... I guess we need more sorcerers also, so might as well just kill this one. Then we need more of those talent knights. I see three more, at least one more over there. We need three more, so it should be easy enough. So that's, honestly, that's by far one of the coolest instances I've ever done. I would say it's one of the cooler ones, absolutely. Like, no question about it. Really fun instance. Glad I looked around and explored a little. Because I think there's a lot that I could have missed there very easily. Like, really easily could have missed all that stuff. I'm sure most people do miss it because it's not obvious. Like, to me, I don't think it's obvious. Let's go do this quest. Where's my hearth set to? Illyrian Stronghold, so right? Yeah, good. It's been a while since I've hearthed. I'm like, where do I hearth to? Drain I have vessels. I need 8 of these. Are these things I loot or things I destroy? Wait. Got them. Gotta loot them. Okay. Turim Hunters. Dead. Boom. Love it. Wait, what? Why did that not work? Okay, I need to figure out what's going on there. I see another one over here. I'm gonna try this one. See if it, oh, I got dazed. That doesn't happen very much. Interesting. So some of those are not real ones, or they don't function properly. That's kind of fun. I guess I need more than 8, basically, right? That's all it's really telling me. It's like 8 is not enough. What is this? Oh yeah, adamantite deposit. No, let's grab that. The good news is, because I can fly, I probably need to fight a lot of these mobs. I mean, really, I just need to, like, hop around and grab my stuff. Flying, once again, kind of trivializing some of these quests out here that are really not designed, or not originally designed with flying in mind. I'm not saying trivialized, but it you know, it does simplify, certainly. Let's get this guy. Oh, there's another one. Nice. How convenient. Although, I don't know why... am I, like, doing something wrong? Huh. I'm gonna read the quest, because I'm obviously being dumb. Okay, I don't know. I'm not really sure where, like, one of those worked and the other few haven't. I'm gonna loot this through the wall. Nice, I'll take that. Of course I'm gonna Chaos Bolt this guy. Got him. You know what I bet it is? I bet there's just, like, different ones of these and I'm not really paying attention. Like, they probably look slightly different and I'm just like, oh, it's all the same thing. But they're not. I don't know. They kind of look similar. Oh, this one's not gonna work. Yep, I see what it is. It's like certain ones, if you highlight over it... Hold on. That one... I don't know what the difference is, but like, if I highlight over this one, it just says Draenei Vessel. But if I highlight over this one, it says Draenei Vessel, and it says Vessels of Power for the quest. And the only ones that seem to be working are the ones that say for the quest also. I don't know why... The quest doesn't seem to indicate... Like, that one shouldn't work. The quest doesn't seem to indicate there's a difference, so I don't know why there's a difference at all. I have no idea, but this one's gonna work. Interesting. I wonder if those are just bugged, or if there's something else that I'm just, like, really unfamiliar with. That one won't work, so I can skip it. Very strange. If anyone has any idea why some of these don't work and some of them do, and why they're, like, labeled as such. Like, I mean, it's obvious once you look at the highlighting of them. It's not like it's even... That one will work. It's really weird. That one in there won't work. That one won't work. That one looks good. And that one looks good. Okay, I'll be done after these two. Huh. That's really weird. This guy's name... I just realized he's a wrecked... Like, W-R-E-K-T, it's a wrecked warrior. As in, like, they got wrecked. That's what I'm thinking. I don't think it actually means that, but that's what I'm going to take it as. I don't even know if W-R-E-K-T was, like R-E-K-T, wrecked, was a slang term back when Burning Crusade launched. I don't think it was. Okay. Where are we headed now? We're going to kill our last of the Stymieing, the Arakoa quest mobs. And then, how much experience do we need to level? We need, we're at 350, so we need like 24,000. I bet if I just skip this quest down here, kill the Shadow Council, and this hearth back and turn in these three, this fourth one, that we will ding. I think that will finish us up. So we'll finish it up, and then next time, finally, I can actually, there's our guy, Ashkaz. Then I can finally actually go to Shadowman Valley for a little while. And from there, let's try Rain of Fire. It seems kind of fun. I don't know, like, why not? Never get a good chance to use this spell out here. Almost killed them all. The guy's like, there's a little bit of health left. All done. Okay, and where is my turn in for these? They're all there. Okay, that was Hearthback. Alarian Stronghold, here we go. So this will definitely ding us. We will hit 67, which is cool. And then I'll finally really go to Shadowwind Valley, which is also cool. And let's start turning in some quests. I think I'll be able to go to Shadowwind Valley, I hope so. Complete quest. Speak with just outside the Sunrise Thicket. Where's that? Oh, yeah. I don't know if I want to go all the way back there. Let's see. Complete quest. I'll take mana potions. Yeah. There we go. 10,000 experience. Ding. Nice. It's exciting. The steam vault has opened up. Looks like Nagas, according to the thumbnail. Ugh. I don't like Naga instances in the Mechanar and the Botanica. How many instances are there? Wow. There's so many. Okay, complete quest. Well, we've dinged. That's the key here. I really do want to go to Shadow Moon. I want to check out some new stuff, not all this. I've been in Terrakar for too long. You know, it was fine. I don't dislike Terrakar, but I'm ready to try something different. Let's take a flight over there now. Where's our flight guy? Fernan Skysword. Wildhammer Stronghold, let's go. So, next episode, we're wrapping up here pretty much. Next episode, we'll definitely start in Shadowwind Valley. As far as instances, what do I have? I mean, I'll probably only do... I'm hoping next episode to hit 68, and that'll be our last Burning Crusade episode. I'm really hoping to push through. That's a fair amount of experience, but I think I can make it happen. I'm honestly tempted to not... Like, now that I, like, dinged this, I'm almost tempted just to, like, run a bunch of instances next episode. Like, just power through... Because it seems like it's a fast way to level. And just kind of power through to get to Northrend. I'd really like to see Northrend. I've been really psyched for that for a while. And I think that's the fastest way, is maybe just, like, just queue up, like, all of these other, like, six. Just queue them all up. Whatever comes up first, I'll run it. Although, I guess if I do a random one, I get a bonus. I may do that. I may run a random dungeon one first, and then I'll queue up for all the other ones, even if it's a repeat, just because I've never actually done this as on this tomb. And I'm curious to see what's in the Satchel of Helpful Goods. Probably some level-appropriate gear, is my guess. But then after that, I might just run a bunch of other ones, and also, I'll, you know, kind of explore Shadowmoon as much as I can, because there are actually quests here now, which is nice. Like, I actually can pick up the quest. That's what I was hoping for. I wasn't sure, but I hoped. So I can actually pick up the quest, which is great. Do I have anything in my bags? I probably do. I probably need a... Ooh, gingerbread cookies. Nice. Restore health. That's really exciting. I need to explore the holiday content, too. I heard there's like a holiday boss and some other stuff I can do. I need to check it out. Is this the end or not? Okay, I was like, well, I wasn't getting rested XP at first. Let's take a... I'll tell you what, if there's one thing, it almost makes me like, I almost get like emotional thinking about it. It's so lame, but I remember in like classic WoW and vanilla WoW, and like the first, I suppose I got like my hair right here is like sticking up. I suppose it's been doing that all morning. I haven't showered yet this morning, so you know, it's coming. So, I remember in like classic WoW, just like, I keep saying classic, but vanilla WoW. I remember in vanilla WoW, and my first character was a gnome mage, and it was my first character out of the beta. I played open beta first. I honestly don't remember what class I played. I didn't play very far. I got a few levels in, basically. My first character on WoW's launch, the day it launched, was a gnome mage named Conald, C-O-N-A-L-D. I mentioned this guy's name before because it was a mix of Arnold Schwarzenegger and Conan the Barbarian. So Conald, Arnold, and Conan, which I thought was a funny name for a gnome. It was a gnome mage. I got to level 26 before I abandoned that gnome. But, anyway, so the gnome, I remember in, like, what was it? In Kuranos the first time I was there, the inn there. I remember there were so many new players, and I just remember, like, sitting in the inn, and there's being people, just, like, tons of people, just, like, hanging out in the inn. Like, no one really knew what we were doing. And every time I'm in one of these, like, sort of dwarven-looking inns like that, I think of that sometimes. Just, like, I remember, like, sitting, like, literally people would sit in the, in the chairs, and they would just, like, chat. It wasn't a role-playing server. Just, like, people would just be like, hey, how's it going? And it was really, everyone was leveling slow. No one had a rush. And I don't think that experience will come back with Classic WoW. But, like, sitting in the inn right now kind of reminds me of that. And, I don't know, it's kind of fun, like, thinking about it. But, anyway, I'm getting a little nostalgic here. But that is all for today. Next time, we'll hopefully hit 68. We will get ready for Northrend content, which is new to me. It really is new to me. And I'm looking forward to that. And I might do, like, just spam some dungeons next episode, really push for 68. So, that's all for today. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.